I, William Wyatt of Salem, a coaster, testify and say that last Monday evening, March the 5th, I was in Boston, down at Treat's dock, where my ship was, when I heard the bells ringing. I suppose there was a fire in the town, so I ran up to the townhouse, and on the south side of it, I saw an officer of the British Army leading 7 or 8 soldiers out of the guardhouse. He was yelling at them to hurry, and he led them down to the custom house on the north side of King Street. I followed them, and when the officer had got there with the men, he told them to get into their formation. I stood just below them on the left, and the officer ordered the men to load their guns. They did this and stood there for about 6 minutes with their guns loaded and bayonets fixed, but not standing in exact order. I saw many young men in the middle of the street facing the British soldiers, about 10 or 12 feet from them. Some of them had sticks in their hands, and they were laughing and shouting and crying, "Fire!" But I did not see any of them throwing anything at the soldiers or threatening any of them. Then the officer moved behind the soldiers on the right side and told the soldiers to fire. When they didn't fire, he told them again to fire. When they still didn't fire, he stamped and said, "Fire! We'll face the consequences later." Then the second man on the left side fired off his gun. Next, a very short pause, they fired one after another as quick as possible, beginning on the right until the last man's gun on the left was out of ammunition. He loaded the gun again and turned his gun on the people who were running away down the street. He turned and fired at them. Immediately after the first firing, I saw 3 of the people fall down in the street. As soon as the last gun was fired, the officer I mentioned before, who had commanded the soldiers to fire, jumped in front of them, waving his sword or stick, and said, "Ye rascals, what did ye fire for?" The soldiers looked confused, and they stopped their firing. Then I went up behind them to the right side, where one of the people was lying, to see whether he was dead. There were 4 or 5 people around him, and one of them said he was dead. Then, as the officer was leaving with the soldiers, I heard a gentleman say, "Captain Preston, keep your men in order and mind what you are about." And that is all I have to report.